Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it rain. Let it
to bless the name of the Lord. Let him hear your voice this morning. Let him hear your voice. Continue to bless his name. Let him hear your words of appreciation to him. Oh, we bless your name, King of Kings, Lord of Lords. We appreciate you. King of Glory, we give you praise. Mighty God, you are worthy. We bless your holy name. We bless your name at all times, and your praise shall continually be in our mouth. You are worthy, O Lord, you are worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy, Jehovah. Jesus, you are worthy, oh Lord, you are worthy, you are worthy to be glorified, you are worthy, oh Lord, you are worthy, you are to be glory. Sing along with me, oh, you are worthy, Jehovah, oh, you are worthy, you are worthy to be glorified, you are worthy, oh Lord, you are worthy. Faithful Jehovah El Shaddai, you are worthy, possessor of the heavens and the earth. You are worthy, you are the King of Glory. You are worthy, we celebrate you here. Jehovah, sing along with me. For us to be here today, we bless your name, Jehovah El Shaddai. Take all the glory, Almighty God. You are worthy to be glorified, Jehovah. You are worthy.The God of Pastor Josiah Akindayoni, the God of Pastor Iyi Adeboye, the God of the Redeemed Christian Church of God all over the world, the God of Jesus Embassy Los Angeles, the God of Pastor Neron Fafowura, the God of all the men and women of God represented here today, we celebrate you.We thank you for the privilege of being alive today. We return all the glory, all honor, all adoration to you. That which you have purposed before the foundations of the world to do in our midst today, Lord, please do in the mighty name of Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed and worshiped. If you are blessed to be in church today, shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shall we please be seated in the presence of the Most High God? I say good day to everyone. I say buenos dias. Sir, I say thank you for the privilege of being here today.To Pastor Mrs. Fafowura, I say thank you. I want you to understand that the apostolic grace is upon our Father and the Lord in this church. Can we celebrate the grace of God upon his life? Somebody said, if I've seen further, it's because I've stood on the shoulders.Of great men. Can we appreciate a great man of God? A great man of God. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm not going to take your time because the Lord gave me that understanding. Because he himself wants to glorify himself in your life and my life today. If you believe that, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you believe that, shout a better hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
We are still going to shout other hallelujah. Because the Lord told me to tell somebody here this morning He said, I should tell you, this is your season of celebration. I'm happy to tell somebody here today that he will change your story. If you believe that, shout a better hallelujah. Before I continue, you are going to rise up on your feet. Today is the 23rd day of February. We are going to shout hallelujah 23 times.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Please, if you are not sick in your body, and if you don't have any issue, please rise up on your feet and let's shout this hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So can we shout it now in Jesus' name? Hallelujah! 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 Put your hands together. For the King of Glory, shall we please be seated? The theme of the message of this morning is divine intervention. Can you open your Bibles quickly to Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3. Jeremiah chapter 33. Verse 3. While we are doing that, can we appreciate the choir? Are you there? If you are there, can you please wave while it's on the screen so you can read together with me? Can we read together? Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. If you believe that will be your testimony today, shout another hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What is divine intervention? It is God changing the outcome positively for those that belong to Him. Number two, it is God stepping into the person's circumstance, or God stepping out for those that remain disobedient to Him. Praise the name of the Lord. Because I remember the story of a sister who was denied a visa to the United Kingdom. And she had been denied several times. But to cut the long story short, she was living in unforgiveness. But immediately she forgave, that situation was turned around. Help me to tell your neighbor, forgive. If you want God to intervene in your situation. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Divine intervention, because of time, requires God's action and man's action. One of the laws of motion says unless another force is applied to a matter, the matter simply stays where it is. So, for example, if James LeBron was to shoot the ball into the basket on the basketball court, if he doesn't do anything with the ball stays in his hands. Praise the name of the Lord. So, but I want you to understand that God is a God who intervenes in the affairs of man. But before we go to that, in that particular scripture, God spoke to Jeremiah, and He's speaking to somebody here today, that if you will call upon Him, then He will show you great mercy. I thought you would say a better amen.
Amen.
It will show you mighty deliverance,
amen.
Mighty victory,
amen.
Mighty restoration.
Amen.
If you believe that, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jeremiah's case was peculiar. He was in captivity. The land was also in captivity. But the summary of it all, if you go to Jeremiah chapter 40, you discover that Jeremiah experienced divine intervention, whereas the other people went into captivity. Why? Jeremiah belonged to God. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He told the truth. He stood for the truth. But then, at the end of the day, he experienced divine intervention. I want to encourage somebody here today. Maybe you are under persecution for the truth. God will show up for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. God is a God of divine intervention. Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 to 3. Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 to 3 says, in the beginning, when there was nothing, God intervened by creating the heavens and the earth. The second verse says, and the earth was without form and void. There was a negative intervention. And then verse 3, God intervened again and said, let there be light. I don't know what contrary thing has intervened in your life. Because you are here today, God will intervene.
Amen.
If you believe that, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God intervened in creation. He stopped disorder and brought about creative order that is sustainable. God will bring about order that is sustainable in somebody's life here today,
amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The other point I want you to know is that God raised people as agents of divine intervention. Jesus' embassy in Ibadan, God raised our pastor as an agent of intervention to bring about that church that was in his mind before the foundations of the world. In Genesis chapter 2 verse 15, God used Adam as an agent of intervention to keep the garden. In Genesis chapter 6 verse 14, Genesis chapter 6 verse 14, God used Noah as a witness of righteousness before judgment. Genesis chapter 12 verse 2, Genesis 12 2, Genesis 13 16, Genesis 13 16, Genesis chapter 22 verse 17 to 18, Genesis chapter 22 verse 17 to 18, we see God raised Abraham and his two children to be an arrowhead of the physical nation of Israel and the spiritual nation that we all belong to today. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In Exodus chapter 3 verse 10, God raised Moses to liberate Israel from bondage. Exodus 3:10. In 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 1, 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 1, God raised David as a king, priest, prophet, and judge to lead a nation according to his own way. In 1 Kings chapter 17 verse 1, 1 Kings chapter 17 verse 1, 1 Kings chapter 19 verse 16, 1 Kings chapter 19 verse 16, God raised Elijah and Elisha to intervene in the affairs of the nation of Israel and beyond the borders to fulfill his will and to establish his counsel. Praise the name of the Lord. Galatians 4 verse 4. Galatians 4 verse 4 tells us, when the fullness of time came, God brought Jesus into the scene as divine intervention so that you and I can experience salvation that was lost in the Garden of Eden. Praise the name of the Lord. So if you are here this morning and you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you are shutting out yourself from God intervening in your life. What is my own story? I came from a family that prayed good boy in church. I did not know God. There was a time in my life I was involved in secret sin, and then God allowed the devil to afflict me. And until I stopped that secret sin, the affliction did not go away. But when I stopped, God intervened. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Fast forwarding the story forward, I began my life as somebody that came to church but did not have a relationship with God. But then the day came, in a particular church, the altar call was made, and I stepped forward to accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. That began a chain of events. God intervened in my life. My life was a life of one under bondage. I was oppressed in dreams. I was involved in some sins, habits that God was not happy with. But immediately I surrendered to Jesus, God came into my life. He washed me inside out and began to use me for His glory. One of the things that happened was that He embellished my natural talents. I play the drum set, and I do play it very well in those days. But then, over time, I saw God lifting me up, skill-wise. I was able to play with people like Lagwaja, some of us know him. I played with Abba Meda himself. I played with his son. Praise the name of the Lord. But then I came to a realization that I needed to glorify God with the gift and talent that He gave me. May I want you to ask your neighbor, who is your life glorifying? Praise the name of the Lord. When I took that decision, I said, Lord, my life will glorify You. I stopped playing music that did not glorify God. And God moved my life to another level. I wrote a song many years ago by the help of the Holy Spirit called Themes from Heaven. A brother brought the song here to the U.S., played it at the Percussive Arts Society meeting, and God healed somebody there of cancer. Praise the name of the Lord. I've seen handkerchiefs, by the grace and mercy of God, we prayed upon, turn the story around. God intervened to give people children that did not have children. I remember we had a workers' training, and God said, give the workers a towel and then pray on it. So we gave all workers towels, we prayed on it, and to the glory of God, somebody died in the neighborhood of one of the workers. They placed the towel, and God raised the man from the dead. In fact, the man was a Muslim, and everybody gave their lives to Christ in that neighborhood. So I want you to know that if you can open the door of your heart to Jesus for Him to come into your life, He will bring about a turnaround in your life. He will take charge and fight for you, do a new thing in your life. I'm not saying that the journey was rosy, because some time ago, I was diagnosed with cervical spondylosis. I mean, it's a big name, but if you have my prayers, I will never experience it, because it comes with a lot of pain. But then God healed me. He intervened. Sometime last year, I identified with the clip. I found it difficult to sleep. But then I cried to God, and God intervened and is helping me. Praise the name of the Lord. So, before I go to your role in divine intervention, the Holy Spirit is a facilitator of intervention. Genesis chapter 1 verse 2. Man was just a form image until the breath of life, the Holy Spirit, came in and he became a living soul. Ezekiel chapter 37, we know that story. The valley of dry bones until the wind of the Holy Ghost came as prophesied by Ezekiel. Dry bones became a mighty army for God. Praise the name of the Lord. We all know the story in Acts chapter 2, when the Holy Ghost came and then the church received the Holy Ghost, the church was given birth to, and which has extended even as I'm speaking. What is your role in divine intervention? Number one, faith in God of intervention. Tell your neighbor, faith in God of intervention. Hebrews 11:6. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. Hebrews 11:6. In four places in the scripture, we have the just shall live by faith. Four places in the scripture. Galatians 3:11. Romans 1:17. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 4. Number two, what is your role in divine intervention? God has his role. Call upon me, and I will show you great and mighty things. That is God. But then you have to play your own role too. Number two, strong thirst and desire for intervention. We are in a season of prayer and fasting. I remember a sister came to us and said, Pastor, my husband asked me to leave the house, and he has somebody else, he's seen somewhere else. Fortunately, it was a time of prayer and fasting as we are now. And we encourage her to take the prayers and fasting intensely. And one thing led to another. As I speak to you, God has restored them back again. So as you thirst and desire for his intervention this morning, God will show up for you in Jesus' name. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Number three, seek God with all your heart. Seek God with all your heart. Jeremiah 29 verse 13. The first time God gave me the privilege of visiting the Holy Land, my prayer was, God, I must never return back the same way I went. It's either I don't return alive or I come back with your intervention in my life. God met me at that level. As you seek God with all your heart, he will show up for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. God does not like half measure. One leg in, one leg out. Shouting hallelujah on Sunday and then becoming somebody else when you go out of the door. God wants us to seek him with all our hearts. It involves our resources. It involves our time. Yes, I know your job schedule is tight, but then you are not in the office 24/7. Praise the name of the Lord. So as you prioritize God in your life, you know, our God is a God without borders. He's a God without space, beyond space and time. You can fellowship with him. I remember the story of a powerful woman in Nigeria who rose to be the manager of a group of government hotels. When she was abroad, she would study in the toilets. Praise the name of the Lord. because she was working several jobs and going to school. So she prioritized her goal of becoming a professional. So she found time to study in the toilet. The Lord will help all of us in the name of Jesus. Like the choir told us, what is your role in intervention? Praise God. Tell your neighbor, praise God.
Praise God.
Tell your neighbor, praising God goes beyond praise and worship in church. Tell your neighbor, praising God has to do with praising Him at all times. Praise the name of the Lord. I remember the story, well, there are so many testimonies. I remember in church one day, the Lord said, ask the people to dance without music, which is a form of praise, and tell them to ask God for something. So a brother said, wow, how can you dance without music? That means the person is wrong, something has gone wrong upstairs. But I said, well, God, if this man is telling us the truth, then I want him to do this. I want you to do this for me. And his testimony was that God did it for him. Tell your neighbor, God will do your own today.
Amen.
If you believe that, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Number five, what is your role in divine intervention? Study the word of God. Study the word of God. General Overseer told us when he was studying the word of God and his family at home, and he got to a place where he says, with God, nothing shall be impossible. And then something clicked. I said, yes, we believe God for intervention in this particular area of our lives. And God intervened. Tell your neighbor, as you study the word of God, as you invest in understanding the word of God, God will intervene in the affairs of your life. I mean, you are blessed to be in the United States. There are so many Bible softwares, so many books. When I look at them online, my mouth begins to water because to have them, you need to be committed to God. But then, I mean, you are here. You have the opportunity. So please tell your neighbor, take advantage of the opportunity. Praise the name of the Lord. Your confession, the man in the clip we watched said it's all in your mind. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, I will live and not die. Tell your neighbor, in this land,
I will prosper.
Tell your neighbor, in this land,
I will excel.
Tell your neighbor, in this land,
I
will fulfill destiny. If you believe that, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shall we rise up on our feet? Prophet, I'm a pastor. I'm going to ask you to touch this as a point of contact. Just touch, and then we allow God to do what He wants to do in our midst.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are going to take some prayer points. Can you please hold somebody while the ushers direct us? Just come. I'm trying to manage time. Come as directed by the ushers. Touch and then go back. I will take some prayers. Praise the name of the Lord. Can we do that simultaneously? We are going to shout hallelujah again. Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah!
We are going to cry to God and say, Father,
by your mercy,
intervene in the affairs of my life today.
Hallelujah.
Shall we turn it to prayer in Jesus' name? Masukarabasura de Dios. By your mercy, intervene in the affairs of my life today. Please just come forward one by one, touch, and go back to your seat. By your mercy, intervene in the affairs of my life today. Masuta le rabba de le toraba santaya. Made le koraba sakalabaya. Made le toraba sakalabaya. In Jesus' name we have prayed. We are going to cry to God and we are going to say, Father, I thank you for the previous intervention in my life. Please do it again in my life today. And that of my neighbor, shall we turn it to prayer in Jesus' name? Made koraba satayaba. Made le toraba sakalabaya. Mrede lego suranaba de lidos. Mantaraba sakalabaya. In Jesus' name we have prayed. You are going to say, Father, you made a way for Daniel. Make way for me in this land. Shall we turn it to prayer in Jesus' name? Made toraba santaya. Mata le toraba sakaya. Rede kobala de ledos. In Jesus' name we are praying. Can I have a better amen, please? I want us to pray this prayer very well. A colleague of mine in secondary school is in Texas. He works in the oil sector. He contested for elections here. He did not win. You understand what I'm saying? You understand what I'm saying? Praise the name of the Lord. So we need to take charge in this land. The mind of God for you and I is to be at the levels where we influence what is going on in this land. Daniel was a stranger in the land, but God gave him influence. We are going to cry to God. We are going to say, Father, you made way for Daniel. Make way for me and my neighbor. Shall we turn it to prayer in Jesus' name? Made toraba sakayaba. Made le tola sakalabaya. Robala de le torabo suradaya. Ride kopara de le dos. In Jesus' name we have prayed. You are going to say, Father. I want you to let's pray this prayer very well. Because God is here. You are going to cry to God. You are going to say, Father. You enthroned Esther and Mordecai, enthrone me and my neighbor in our place of destiny. Shall we turn it to prayer in Jesus' name? Made toraba sakaya, rita kabala de dedos, made garabo suranabaya, made le toraba sakaya, made le toraba sudeladaya. Maile korobo suradaya. In Jesus' name we have prayed. You are going to say, Father, whatever you need to uproot in my life, uproot. And my neighbor, shall we turn it to prayer in Jesus' name? Whatever you need to uproot in my life, and that of my neighbor, do so in the mighty name of Jesus. Madale to rabasadaya. Mada leto la sakabaya, rabada leto le padale dos, male karabashadeya, ropa la da leto la santaya. In Jesus' name we have prayed. You are going to say, Father, whatever you need to plant, to create for my intervention, do so today in Jesus' name. Shall we turn it to prayer in Jesus' name? Mane toraba sakaya. Maita la sura rabadeya. Made le torabo sokalabaya. Made le toraba sataya. Ripa le nelego sura rabaya. Made le torabo sura deya. Rede kobala de le toraba saya. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Please hold somebody because in agreement there is power. You are going to say, Father, send help to me today and my neighbor. Shall we turn it to prayer in Jesus' name? Madale suranabaya. Oh, the addition of today, send it to me and my neighbor. Maile korabasadaya. You are the help of the helpless. Send help to me today. Rabalaga le korabo suradaya. Mai le koraba sadaya. Madale to la sakabaya. In Jesus' name we have prayed. We are going to say, Father, show that the earth is yours and the fullness thereof. In my life and that of my neighbor, shall we turn into prayer in Jesus' name? Show that the earth belongs to you and the fullness thereof. In my life and that of my neighbor. Rabadele koraba sutayaba. Male dele koraba zarayaya. Rubala dele norabo suradeya. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Before I ask you to pray your own personal prayer points, every eye closed and every head bowed, I want to give somebody here an opportunity to open themselves up for divine intervention. Maybe you are here this morning, you have never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. The opportunity is here this morning because he is knocking at the door of your heart. The choice is yours to open to him, then he will come in to intervene in the affairs of your life. Or you are here, you know that you have left God. God is calling you back home again. Because he said, if wherever you have been, whatever you have done, wherever you have found yourself, the door is still open for those that return back to him. If we have anybody in that category, can you just raise your right hand to heaven so that we can pray together? You are here, you want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Or you want to rededicate your life back to him? Can I just see your hands? Do you have anybody in the house? You want to rededicate your life back to Christ? Or you want to accept him as your Lord and Savior? Thank you, my brother. Do you have any other body in the house? Any person else in the house? You want to accept him as your Lord and Savior? Or you want to come back to him? Can the ushers just help my brother forward so that I can pray for him? Is there another person? Ushers, please help my brother forward. Is there another person? You want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Or you want to rededicate your life to him? Back to him. Can you please help him to come forward? For the last time, you want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, or you have departed from him and you want to return, the door is open for you this morning or this afternoon. God is here, wants to do a new thing in your life. Shall we just stretch our hands to my brother in front? Father, we thank you for your son that has hearkened to you this morning. Father, please show him your mercy. He has identified with you publicly in every area of his life. Father, please identify with him. Let today be a turning point for good in his life. In Jesus' name we have prayed. At the beginning of this, the Lord told me, he said, don't waste the people's time because I want to walk in their life. I want you to raise your two hands to heaven. Please let's respect the presence of God, the owner of the church himself, I'm talking of the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Godhead. He is your resident director of the affairs of the body of Christ on earth right now. Dear Holy Spirit, you're already here. You said you are here to glorify Jesus. You are here to move in our midst as you will. So therefore, we leave the floor open to you now, dear Holy Spirit. This is your time. This is your time. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Glorify Jesus. Yes. Yes. Holy Spirit. Yes. Yes. Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Yes. Come and glorify Jesus. Come and glorify Jesus. Move in our midst. Unhindered, move in our midst now. Move in our midst now. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, glorify Jesus. 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 Can we please be silent before him now? Of my voice, including myself, we shall return with joy,
amen.
Gladness,
amen.
Victories,
amen.
Healings,
amen.
Testimonies of God's goodness,
amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Blessed be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Shall we put our hands together?
Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of hell.
Sing out.
Let it rain.